Welcome back. You've joined us on Big Deal, and let's take it straight across to Sanjeev Krishan of PWC joining us from Delhi. Sanjeev, so good to have you on CNBC-TV18. Now, I have been speaking to many private equity players. Like last week, it was Blackstone and Brookfield. Then we had Warburg Pincus as well as Chris Capital this time. And the overall private equity capital is becoming extremely important, especially for the stressed asset space. Do you think that more and more, especially global private equity firms, are getting more comfortable in involving themselves in IBC processes as well?
Definitely. I think if you look at the last 2 years, the IBC has definitely matured. I think it continues to reinvent itself. And from an investor standpoint, today there are multiple opportunities. They can participate in a direct sale process. They can actually buy debt. They can actually buy a portfolio of banks' balance sheets, so, and release capital for banks. So in some ways, there are multiple opportunities for stress asset investors, and not just the stress asset investors who actually just focus on stress, but also investors like, as you mentioned, some of the names. They are actually now focusing on stress as a big theme in India. So stress is going to be a big theme, and it's already contributing very significant numbers in terms of M&A activity in 2018.
That's right, Sanjeev. And in fact, stress is not just coming in because of the NPAs that the banks had seen and because of which IBC processes had started. But now with the little bit of crisis that we saw in some of the NBFC companies, and there is an understanding that there could be more pain which could come out later, and therefore the pressure that is mounting on the real estate space, that is also seeing a fair bit of action. What do you have to say about that?
Yeah, so I would say three things. I think just to complete the IBC matter, I think, you know, the pre-IBC situations are very interesting for private equity investors, and that will continue to be a big theme. I think secondly, as you mentioned again, and very rightly so, there is some amount of stress building in. We can see that the public markets are struggling, and I think from a private equity standpoint, they love this situation because this would mean that they have a greater opportunity to deploy capital. And then coming, of course, to the real estate space, I think I do agree. I think the commercial real estate has seen significant amount of transactions already in the year gone by, over the last 18 months or so. I think there are other pockets of opportunity which are there. And then, of course, there are possibilities for secondary or tertiary transactions in the commercial real estate space. So I would think that all those three would be big opportunities for 2019. I do believe that 2019 could be a bigger year for private capital because the public markets will be soft for a large part of the year.
Right. And we've already seen some of the fund action when it comes to the stressed space, may not be IBC, but definitely like CDPQ investing in an NBFC, Edelweiss, of course, taking forward their relationship, and also Brookfield looking to sign the deal with Hotel Leela Ventures. So all these are signs, even the prominence of Canadian pension funds coming out quite starkingly now, which had already invested quite a bit some time back, and now are looking and training their eyes towards the stressed asset space as well, Sanjeev.
I do agree. And, you know, completely, you know, if you look at the whole non-banking financial space, I think they would definitely have a situation where liquidity is available by various means and ways. The cost of liquidity will go up. So, for instance, the transaction that you mentioned, the CDPQ one, and, you know, some of the others are going to be more and more visible. I think from an NBFC standpoint, there is a possibility for greater consolidation to happen. And, you know, it's a space that the private equity investors love. They have actually been investing on the growth cycle, particularly with the housing finance companies and others. And I think today there is an opportunity for them to participate on a selective basis, depending on where the criteria allows them, in consolidation of the whole NBFC space. So that, I think, I do agree, that's a big space for private equity investors in 2019.
And what about the other sectors? Which are the sectors outside of stress situations which you see are gaining more attention from the private equity sector?
So, you know, from a private equity standpoint, I think, you know, even if we look that if this is going to be a year in which there is going to be, let's say, muted growth, or it's going to be a bit of an India down scenario, you know, in an India down scenario, sectors like pharmaceutical, technology obviously come back. You know, we always see a significant amount of interest in the consumer and the financial services space. And again, you know, if you look at the kind of frenzied activity that we're currently seeing in the infrastructure space, particularly on the road side, as well as on the renewable side, I think that's something which, to my mind, will create the biggest numbers for 2019. I think real estate will continue to be an important element, and supplemented by the pre-stressed situations like the hospitality deal that you mentioned. I think those are the six or seven spaces segments where I would believe there will be maximum activity in 2019 from a PE standpoint.
Would you agree with me if I say that more or less most of the private equity players would be more in an investment mode than exit mode, also because of market volatility and therefore dampening of valuations, not giving an exit route at this point compared to what we saw a couple of years back, where most of the IPOs were really done to give an exit to private equity?
Absolutely, Nisha. I mean, if you look at it last year, it is a blockbuster year for exits. And I think a lot of funds have actually exited a significant amount of their investments, number of their investments. So the stress that people used to say, I think, has gone from an exit standpoint. And I would like to believe, and with fundraising has been pretty decent as well. So with good fundraising, exits done in 2018, I would think that 2019 is going to be an investing year more than ever before. And you know, I won't be surprised if we do cross the $40 billion threshold in 2019.
All right, so that's a big number. Thanks so much, Sanjeev, for joining us here on CNBC-TV18. So that's the really word coming in from the entire private equity sector. Of course, it's gaining a lot of prominence when it comes to providing capital for growth in the Indian companies while the strategics are saddled with their debt concerns. With that, we wrap it here on Big Deal, but stay tuned to CNBC-TV18.